heard in that report lots of people there in Brazil, but we also know in the U.S. Relying on deliveries for their groceries, ordering them online. There's been an increase in those deliveries. It's obviously convenient, but what about the risks to the people delivering them, to the people receiving them?
Good afternoon. Yes, I think there's been a concern all over the world. I think so far what the critical aspects that we need to be concerned is the maintaining our distance, because the transmission is normally believed that is person to person. So first of all, for either the person delivering or the person picking it up, I think make sure that you maintain distance.
And what about some of the information that's out there about deliveries? I've seen all sorts of things about leave your groceries in the bags outside for 3 days, people concerned about Amazon shipment boxes, if you should bring them in. Is there a source of good, reliable information? Who should we be listening to?
Well, in the U.S., the CDC website has been very actively updating their information for every segment of our society. There is a really nice page for consumers on the recommendations of what you do when you go to the supermarket, when you buy groceries. Also, the FDA has a good number of recommendations for employers for any of the outlets of companies delivering food or retail or establishment. So, and on top of that, I'm sure every single government in the world is being very proactive. And of course, the website of WHO is very proactively putting out materials for consumers.
Many people are still venturing out to stores. Some places putting in place policies, safety measures, requiring masks when they enter. It seems that the store workers are the ones that are most often exposed. What sort of safety measures are you aware of that have been put in place to protect the workers and the shoppers?
Well, first of all, employers are trying to monitor employees that they're working at either food processing plants or at the retail outlets. So I guess the first line of defense is monitor sick employees. So a number of employers are deploying temperature measuring devices for employees, and they're actively asking their employees to disclose their health status. At the same time, the employers they are being provided protective equipment. They're being provided sanitizing materials, the key factor here is make sure to ensure some level of distancing of each other between employees and between employees and consumers. The employees are really one of those in the food outlets, definitely are some of the unsung heroes of this crisis. They're really working hardly to make sure that all the surfaces in their places are going to be protected for consumers to when they're going to be sorting through their groceries or the food selection.